I'm Dr. Vandana Hegde. I'm a practicing infertility specialist at Hegde Fertility Center at Hyderabad, Telangana. I've been in the field of reproductive medicine for more than a decade now. Today we've been seeing that there's a rising awareness in infertility, and the most important condition that we see that is becoming more common now is the decreased ovarian reserve or the poor ovarian reserve, and it's a very important topic for young girls also today. Yeah, poor ovarian reserve is basically a woman with less number of eggs at her reproductive age with decreased fertility potential. So what is important with poor ovarian reserve is because women are not aware of it. See, there are no symptoms of poor ovarian reserve. Like if you think of diabetes, if you think of any condition, any medical condition, a patient presents with symptoms. Means they will have an indication that yes, they have some disease in them. Whereas poor ovarian reserve is a condition where a woman is not aware at all. So there are no symptoms. See, very rarely when the reserve goes so low, then she's reaching somewhere around the perimenopause range. That is when she may have certain symptoms. Genetic risk. See, most of the time, a woman, when will she attain puberty and when she will attain menopause? The reproductive phase of her career is something that cannot be changed medically. The time of her first periods and the time of her menopause. So this is mostly genetically determined. That means the egg reserve is already genetically determined. So this is something that will not change or cannot be increased. But there are certain medical conditions where it may decrease, which may accelerate this poor ovarian reserve. And few of them are if there is an antibody mediated disease, like if they are suffering from diabetes. Also, there could be other conditions where there has been a decreased blood supply to their ovaries, like if they have had a previous pelvic surgeries for any conditions like ectopic pregnancy or endometriosis. Especially endometriosis is a disease which affects the reproductive system. The other part would be the infections where they have genital infections. Mostly it is in India, the most common condition is tuberculosis. So when there's a tuberculosis or other bacterial infections like PID, they also can sometimes decrease the egg reserve. So these things can lead to repeated miscarriage. So either they present to us with irregular cycles or with difficulty in conception or with repeated pregnancy loss. So these are the most common symptoms. So I would tell you the majority of the poor ovarian reserve could be asymptomatic, because today we are seeing in very young girls. So these are girls who are not even married, who are still yet to in their study phase or in their early career phase. And they are the girls who come to us mainly with just a very vague symptoms with respect to their cycle changes. And they also may having a poor ovarian reserve. So there is no age bar for presenting with these symptoms. It's not just in older women, but we also see this in very young girls also. Diagnosed through two techniques. The most important one that I would recommend is the ultrasound scan, because in ultrasound scan we get to see their uterus and their ovaries. So this is called the antral follicle count. In a short form we call it as the AFC. So the AFC scan done during the early phase of our menstrual period gives us an indication regarding her egg reserve. So in blood test we have varied types of tests. There is an FSH test, there is an estradiol test, and there is an AMH test. So FSH stands for follicle stimulating hormone, and estradiol. So both these blood tests are done during the early phase of their menstrual cycle, preferably on period second day or the third day of their cycle. So we have various cutoffs depending on which we can diagnose if they come under the poor ovarian reserve. And AMH or the anti-Mullerian hormone test is another blood test which is more of a confirmatory nature. That is the IVF is there, there is IUI, there is ICSI, and there is PGS. But what I would mainly tell with respect to the poor ovarian reserve is to plan early. Because see, whatever treatments we just spoke about, they do have, yes, there are limitations. None of these are all 100% successful. They all vary in their success rate somewhere between around 40 to 50%. So if you look at treatment wise, I would suggest them to go early on for treatments. So today there are a lot of medications that try to improve your egg quality. So you can take those medicines to improve egg quality and go faster towards fertility treatments, because the success rate of fertility treatments also decreases with advancing age. So there is no point in postponing fertility treatments like IVF. So when it is indicated, it is best to go for that. also in young couples, I would suggest that not to go for early abortions and all that, because as I said, one of the reasons for decreasing egg reserve could be infections, could be ectopic pregnancies which land up in surgeries. Similar to IVF, where we stimulate their ovaries, we take out their oocytes and freeze it for their future use. Doctors also, we can only probably tell you that this is the situation now, which we can't change, because the changes that that age has brought could not be reversed, because IVF is a very successful treatment if done at the right time and done in the right way. So I think it's time that you people take your first step, this you're meeting your doctor.